Welcome back. If you've been following the series on ECU chipping, if you're new to the channel or new to the video, please hit the like and subscribe button. This is going to be how to install a VTEC switch into a non-VTEC ECU, essentially turning a non-VTEC P06 ECU into an electrically equivalent P28 ECU. So this is just a strictly informational video. Whatever you do to your ECU, any damages or anything you do is strictly on you. You cannot hold myself liable or our sponsor, HA Motorsports, Honda Acura Management, Engine Management Solutions. They were gracious enough to send me this entire chipping kit selection. So today we will be diving into the 1720 VTEC conversion kit. And the reason why we're doing the 1720 is because the board we're working on is a 1720 board. There's three different types of boards, so just be careful and look at the number that you're getting for your board. This is a 1720 board, so we will use the 1720 VTEC kit. Let's get this VTEC kit laid out and see what we have. Okay, we got everything laid out for the VTEC conversion in the 1720 kit. We've got a diode, a conditioning capacitor, a resistor, an SK high switch for the VTEC, and a transistor. And then we have a pack of three resistors labeled RM11. I believe RM stands for resistor module, which is right here. And the RM11 on the board is not available. So you'd have to take those three resistors and make your own resistor pack. Fortunately, this board has one. I do have another board without an RM11. So if you guys want a video, drop a comment in the box below and I'll make another video on it. Now that we got everything laid out, the areas we want to desolder are the IC4 latch here, those five dots, and the D11 over here, the diode 11. So we're going to start with those two areas first and get those desoldered. Okay, we got the areas desoldered. Let's take a look at them real quick before we get into dropping the components in. So we see we have the IC4, the five pins disconnect or desoldered there. The R67 right there, resistor 67. We also have C60 here. And J10. So these are all in the same area, upper left corner here. You're going to desolder D11 here, diode 11, upper left corner. And then come to the middle of the board, you're going to see Q26 underneath the center ECU support. You can get to it without it, without dropping the case if you're skilled. If not, take the ECU out of the case. But those are all the pieces that you need to desolder. Let's start dropping the components in and getting things ready to go. Alright, so just want to make a note about the C. Alright, let me get that in focus there. About the C60 slot. On this, and it's very hard to get focus on this thing. Alright, you see a little plus sign on the right hand side there. With a, I guess, an upside down L above it, right on the right hand side here. That's going to correspond, that plus sign has got to correspond with that plus sign right there. So make sure that you get that right. Because if you don't get the plus side, which is the long leg on the left, the plus side is the long leg on the left. Get it down in there, push it down. And just leave a little air gap above the board for it. Same thing for that diode over there. That diode's got the silver strip. You see how it's got the strip right there next to it? Make sure they're in the right polarity. Okay, we got all the components soldered in and on the board. So let's look closely at every component we installed. If you look closely right here, we have the diode number 11 which is right there. Let me get a better camera angle for you guys. Diode 11, which is right there. Notice the silver strip is facing the terminal ECU plugs. The next part that needed to be installed was the R67 resistor right here. No polarity, doesn't matter what side it's in. Then we have the VTEC high side SK switch right here, which is IC14. We had to put in the C60 conditioning capacitor, the J10 0 ohm jumper wire, and the Q26 transistor underneath the center support on the ECU. So that's it. That's everything that's needed to convert a non-VTEC ECU into an electrically equivalent VTEC ECU. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.